Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you MAC protocols for sensor network. MAC means Media Access Control Protocols. I have made this video in context of IoT. Let me show you outlines of this video first. So in this video, first I'll explain you basics of MAC protocols. Then I'll explain you different types of MAC protocols, where I'll compare three different types of MAC protocols where comparison is there based on channel allocation. So there are three categories that I'll be comparing based on varieties of parameters. At last, I'll explain you SMAC and EAR MAC protocols that we widely used in IoT as well as that we widely used in wireless sensor network. So let us start this video with first agenda, that is basics of MAC protocols. See, MAC protocols establish the infrastructure for communication among the sensor nodes. So here in sensor network, there are sensor nodes, or you can say sensor devices. Those sensors are communicating with gateway. So how that communication happens? For that infrastructure, that is being provided by media access control protocols. Here, when you talk about sensor network, then you need to focus about key parameters. Those are power efficiency, topology change, and global synchronization. When it comes to power efficiency, you should know sensor nodes are operated with battery. So power efficiency is very essential parameters when it comes to sensor network or when it comes to IoT. See, topology change, that is also very essential parameter. Why? The reason is, here these sensor nodes are mobile in nature, means there is a mobility with sensor nodes. So topology also changes with respect to time. So based on change in topology, how media access control protocol functions, that we need to understand over here. So that even I'll explain you by few examples, so that will give you more clarity. As well as global synchronization, that is also very essential parameter. Global synchronization means whatever data that is been forwarded by sensor, that should get synchronized on cloud. That is how global synchronization is happening. So how data transfer happens, that is also very essential parameters. So these are the basics. Now let us talk about different types of MAC protocols. When you talk about channel allocation of sensor node, then based on channel allocation, in general, there are three categories. One is fixed allocation, second is demand based allocation, and third is contention based allocation. So based on channel allocation, MAC protocols can be classified in three categories. Let us compare those three categories with respect to varieties of parameters. So here parameters are there, and I'll compare fixed allocation, demand based allocation, and contention based allocation MAC protocols. So first parameter is channel allocation. See, in fixed allocation, common channel is shared among the node. So for all the node, there will be common channel, right? And by common channel, all the nodes will be communicating to the gateway, that one can say. See, in demand based allocation, channel allocation is there based on demand of the node. So as if node is demanding for data transfer, then for that particular node, channel will be allocated. So in demand based, channel allocation will be there based on demand of the node. And third is contention based. So in that, random access contention based protocols will be there. In practice, right now, Aloha and slotted Aloha, those are random access protocol for contention based, right? Second parameter is traffic, or one can say data rate. See, with fixed allocation, you will be observing it is suitable for fixed or deterministic data rate. So all the nodes are having fixed data rate, or one can say deterministic data rate, right? As they are having common channel, right? In demand based, it is suitable for variable data rate. Why it is suitable for variable data rate? The reason is here nodes are demanding for channel. So based on demand, channel will be allocated to the node. So as if node is there in sleep mode, then it will not be occupying any channel, means there is no data rate. But as if channel is allocated, in that situation, it will be accessing channel by some data rate. So here there will be variable data rate in demand based. In contention based, it is suitable for bursty traffic. Bursty traffic means if so many nodes wants to access data at a time, then contention based media access control protocol that comes into the picture, right? So that is how traffic that is there with different protocols, right? When you talk about data overhead means extra data that we added along with the data. For example, if you measure temperature, so along with the data of temperature, you will be adding overheads of source, destination, and how to route the data, security, everything is there in overhead, right? So extra data that one can say, which is overhead. So in fixed allocation, minimum overhead will be there. In demand based allocation, additional overhead that we added because of reservation process. There are some protocols in MAC in which we do reservation of channel. So as if channel is having reservation, then for that reservation, additional overhead is added. In contention based, some overhead is there due to random access of channel, right? So minimum overhead that will be there with fixed. In demand based, overhead will be there based on reservation, and in contention based, overhead is there because of random access. Next parameter is delay. See, with fixed allocation, fixed delay will be there. In demand based, variable delay will be there. See, here delay is there based on reservation. So once turn will come for that particular node, for that it will have to wait, right? So variable delay will be there. In contention based, random delay will be there. See, random delay and variable delay both are different. Variable delay means how reservation is provided. So for that delay may be different, but that is well defined. While in random delay, what happens when so many nodes are accessing channel at a time, some nodes may not be able to access the channel. So for those nodes, delay will be random, right? So with contention based, random delay will be there. In demand based, variable delay will be there, right? Next parameter is collision probability. In fixed allocation, you will be having minimum collision probability. In demand based, moderate collision probability will be there. And in random access, more collision will happen, right? And this contention based protocol are not suitable for real-time applications. Now I'll explain you SMAC and EAR MAC protocols. Let me explain you the meaning of these two protocols first. See, SMAC means sensor media access control. So how sensor will be accessing media and how it is getting controlled, that has been defined by this SMAC protocol. What are the functions that is been done by SMAC? So it is used for network initialization. It is the distributed protocol. It does neighbor discovery as well as channel assignment. I'll show you one practical example that will give you more clarity. See, SMAC is sensor media access control protocol. It is used for network initialization. It is distributed protocol. It does two another task, neighbor discovery as well as channel assignment. And when it comes to EAR, that is energy and activity aware routing. So here, based on energy and activity, how routing should be done, that has been defined by EAR protocol. Like when communication happens at a time, two nodes may be stationary or two nodes may be mobile. Mobile means those are moving. So as if they are moving far from each other, then power transmission should be high. If they are nearer to each other, then power of transmission that should be low. So here EAR, that defines energy and activity aware for routing. Now let me show you one practical example by which you will get to know like how SMAC and EAR that is essential. So let us assume we are having one sensor node over here. Let us say that is node A. Now in this node A, let us assume second node comes into the vicinity. So you can observe in the vicinity of A, node B is coming. Now, as if you want to provide communication in between A and B, then first of all, you will have to initialize network. That is been done by SMAC. You see how. First, A will give initialization message to B. In that message, what it does is, it will give ID of A and comma zero that is written. Comma zero means what? It is saying in the vicinity of A, zero nodes are there. Means A is in contact with zero nodes right now. Then B will give reply. So that is response message. In that response message, B will be giving ID of its own as well as it will give ID of A. In that response, what it says is my ID is B, your ID is A, and in my contact there are zero sensors, right? So first A is saying like my ID is A and I'm in contact with zero nodes, and then B is saying my ID is B, your ID is A, and I'm in contact of zero people. So that is how they are initializing network. Now see channel assignment that we need to understand. See here it have done neighbors discovery. Here A have done neighbors discovery. Now A got to know, oh, I am in the contact of B. That is how it have done neighbors discovery, right? Now for channel assignment, A will be forwarding one link message. So in that it will be saying, I want to establish a link with you. So link message to B, it will be forwarding one message. Now in response to this, B will forward a message in which it will specify link specification. So link data will be given. In that link data, it will be saying with this data rate, we can communicate with each other, right? Or it can say by this distance I am available. So you should be transmitting data with this much amount of power. So link specification message that is forwarded by B. So here you see with the use of SMAC protocol, we have done neighbors discovery as well as channel assignment, right? Now see EAR protocol does what? EAR protocol does energy efficient routing. Now what is the meaning of energy efficient routing? See here, as I have told you, this B is coming in the vicinity of A. That's why A and B are communicating with each other. So it is obviously possible B will be further moving somewhere over here. So as if B is going nearer to A, then that transmission power that should go down. And as if B is going far from A, then transmission power that should go up. That has been defined by EAR protocol. That is how these two protocols play very essential roles in media access control. I hope you have understood all those things. See, there are many media access control protocols like TDMA, FDMA, like carrier sense multiple access. In carrier sense multiple access also, there are many protocols. All those protocols that I have covered in my lecture series of computer network. So I'm not going to explain you all those protocols here in this video lecture series of IoT. If you want to learn all those protocols, you just go through my video lecture series of computer network where I have covered almost all the protocols which we need to have it with computer network, right? But here I have made this video specifically for IoT. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.